What's up, everybody, and welcome back to the channel and another inning program breakdown video. Today we have the sixth inning program. We're gonna break down everything for you guys. We're gonna go over the bosses first, but guys, if you go on to enjoy this type of video, make sure to hit the like and subscribe button for more content like this. We break down every single program, every single thing that comes into the game. Obviously, we want to see the bosses first. So as we open this pack, it is 99 overall Ken Griffey Jr., 99 overall Mike Piazza, 99 overall Jackie Robinson. These cards look amazing. Ken Griffey Jr. we've already seen, but we'll go over it again. 110, 100 contact, 114, 109 power, 105 vision, a monster fielding, great arm strength, great speed. This guy is a five-tool player. No need to say anything else about it. There's a video already on my channel about Ken Griffey Jr. That card looks amazing. Mike Piazza, the catcher. Oh my goodness. This card is stacked. The first, seven hitting stats, all above 100. This is one of the best hitters in the game. You give up some defense, but 116, 125 contact is legit. 109, 115 power is also legit. 111 vision is amazing. He can also play first. He's going to have bronze fielding over there, I believe. 45 speed is not amazing, but Mike Piazza is going to mash. Jackie Robinson, 99 overall. This guy is a pure contact guy. He's similar to Tony Gwynn with a little bit less contact, but the card reminds me a lot of Tony Gwynn with less arm, and then also he's a second baseman. 119, 182, 119, 122 contact, 80, 79 power, 125 vision, 99 bunting, 86 fielding at second is good. The arm strength doesn't need to be great. I wouldn't use him at third though because the arm strength is low. 95 speed is amazing. Jackie Robinson looks amazing. In my opinion, he's the worst of the bosses. I think you can't go wrong with Griffey or Piazza. I think if you needed a second baseman, Jackie Robinson fits the bill. But honestly, I feel like Griffey and Piazza are too good to pass up. But if you're a big Dodgers fan, maybe Jackie Robinson is the move. So let's go over the first part of the sixth inning program now. Obviously, gear up, choice packs, animations pack. There's like this weird dragon thing, if you can see through that. I'm not going to spend too much time on the not player side of it. At 100 stars, you get a choice pack. It is Lefty Grove, Mark Melanson, and then Eric Davis. Lefty Grove, I believe, was a World Series reward, or still is, maybe. Eric Davis was a flawless reward. Mark Melanson is here. Let's look at him. Lefty Grove looks awful, except for the stamina. Just nothing except for the stamina looks good on this card. I mean, 73, 77. I guess it's above average, but I don't think it's diamond level. The stamina definitely brings the card overall up, like, really high. So this is a card I wouldn't pick, probably, unless you're a big Lefty Grove fan. And then also the control I don't think is great, they said on the stream. So that card, to me, is not very appealing. If you need pen help, Mark Melanson is going to do that for you. 88, 80, hits and Ks for 9, 96, 94, walks and home runs for 9 with 90 clutch and 90 control. Not the fastest velo ever, but he's got some good break. Mark Melanson is going to be a good pen option if you don't have a lot of depth there. And then, of course, Eric Davis, everything above 80. He's got 106 contact, 82, 80, and then 80 to finish out the first four attributes. 61 vision is not amazing, but it's fine. Right fielder can also play left field and center field, as is pretty normal for a lot of outfielders. 62 speed is... or 61 speed is not the fastest ever, but it's okay, it'll get by. 62 fielding is really bad. 68 arm strength is also bad. I don't know, this seems like it'll be a situational bat at best. So none of these cards, except for Melanson in my opinion, are great. These are the 100 stars ones. At 120 you get a pack. At 140 stars you get a Ken Griffey universal nameplate. That'll be pretty cool. Stubs, another pack. 200 stars. This is legit. This pack to me is so exciting. obviously here as they load up. You have Matt Carpenter, 95 overall third baseman, a Lightning player. You have Catfish Hunter, a starting pitcher from the Oakland Athletics. Dante Bichette gets his Signature Series card, obviously one of the rewards for the Rockies deal that you did earlier in the year. But let's go over him. We'll go over Matt Carpenter first because he's on the far left. Matt Carpenter plays third base, first base, and second base. He can't play short, but the hitting is phenomenal. 104, 91 contact, 89, 84 power, 94 vision, 122 discipline, 105 clutch. 49 bunting is whatever. I think the card is going to mash. The fielding's also really good. 78 fielding is passable. 71 arm strength is, I feel like it's good enough for third. It's nothing amazing, but it'll be okay. 89 arm accuracy. He's going to have a pretty big window there if you use button accuracy. 53 speed, again, is pretty good. Catfish Hunter, another starting pitcher here. I think he's going to be really good. He's much better than Lefty Grove, obviously, as you would expect. 120 stamina. This guy's going to pitch complete game after complete game. Hits and Ks per 9, good. Walks and home runs per 9, good. 96, 82, 91, 81, obviously. 97 clutch. He's got 90 control. He's going to throw the pitch where you want him to. The velocity's not great, but the break is really good. Here are the hitting stats if you're curious in that. It seems like every time I break down a pitcher, people are like, where are the hitting stats? Well, here you go, angry commenter. The next guy, Dante Bichette, 95 overall from the Rockies. He is going to mash. 107, 109 contact, 86, 91 power with 100 vision is amazing. 67 fielding, also not great, but passable, I feel like, in right. I would use him in left, to be honest with everyone. And then you have arm strength at 80, which is pretty good. Dante Bichette, I guess, could run a little bit. He has 66 speed. Really good card. Really, in this pack, I don't think there's any wrong choice. Just pick what your team needs the most. I need a third baseman, honestly, so I'm probably going to go with Matt Carpenter. He seems like he's going to be the move for me. But Catfish Hunter looks good. Dante Bichette also looks good. It's just pick your poison. Any of these three look amazing. At 220 stars, you get a home run call, packs. You get the digital camo bat skin. That looks cool, I guess. Ballin' is a habit pack at 280 like is normal. If you go above and beyond, you get camo at 425, an alarm sound. I don't know why you would want that, but 2500 stubs. At 500 stars, you get a June monthly awards pack. This pack is the one with LeMahieu, Lance Lynn, Liam Hendricks, Yordan Alvarez, then the golds are Kingery, Gallegos, Sogard, and however you say that last name, Yamamoto. It's not a guarantee that you get a diamond. It's still a possibility you roll gold, they said. So prepare yourself to get here and be stuck with Scott Kingery as your best option. However, if you get lucky, you could get one of these four diamond cards, and they look sick. I think all of them have proved that they're solid cards. If you get all the way to 600 stars, you get the Signature Series Choice Pack. Obviously, you get a roll 1 in 10 there for the rare round, which is the 99. So you have Feller, Kaline, Carter, and Kenley, and Sandberg. And then you have mid-tier, which is, what, Hanley, Braun, Votto, Brett, and Granderson. Then the base tier, Ozzy, Ian, Keith Hernandez, Russell Martin, and Ricky and Keel. So if you get to 600 stars, you have a chance at the Choice Pack, and that is pretty dope. So how do you get stars? Well, pretty much the same way you get stars every other time we have an innings program. You have 10 wins, gets you 30 stars in either ranked, battle royale, or events, just 10 total online wins. Then you have Conquest. The 6th inning Conquest board looks like a Mariners trident, which is fitting because it's Griffey week. So they said this will not be as stacked rewards wise as the Shark week, which I think is fine. That was a cool one-time deal, and maybe later in the year they'll do it again. But the thing that's cool about this one is you're not in a hurry to really capture anything. It's just capture one stronghold, you get stubs, steal 3 million fans, you get Stubbs. There's no, like, what's the word I'm looking for here? There's no time-based things that you need to do. So, I think it works out really well. There's only, what, 5 strongholds you have to do on this? It's a pretty easy map, it looks like. So, just do it, you get 30 free stars. I believe that is going to do it for the video, guys. That is the entire 6th inning program. I'll have a video later today on the new Headliners pack. And yeah, that's going to do it for the video. Make sure to leave a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. That is everything you need to know about the 6th inning program. And I will catch you guys in the next one.